Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hany Ismail from Planning Engineer website. Welcome to the execution and controlling phase. In this lesson, we are going to start our execution and controlling phase, and we are going to start with the earned value management. Okay, we discussed the earned value management previously in the planning, but now since the project starts, the contractor will start to execute the project according to the plan. We need to say whether we are on time, it means are in a good shape or ahead of schedule. We need to see if we are on budget or under the budget. We see to if we are complying with the specification, which is the quality control. So now we are going to discuss the term is whether we are or not on time or behind the schedule. So are we executing the project as needed? What do we mean if we are on plan? We discussed before the triangle of the project management, time, cost, and quality. So let's see how we can find out if we are on plan. But before doing this, let's recap about what we discussed so far and how the project starts and what is the life cycle of the project. The project starts with an idea. This idea is developed to be initial project, and then we start to do the planning after the initiation phase where we have the tender and we select the proper contractor. Then we start, after awarding the project, we start doing the planning. Then we start doing the execution, okay, of the project and monitoring. These two steps are in parallel. So in the same time we are executing the project, we are monitoring the progress. So we have one of two cases, whether we are on plan or we are not on plan. If we are on plan, okay, everything is good, no need to take any actions. If we are not on plan, we need to find what are the causes and take corrective actions. So this is the life cycle of the project from a project management point of view. Now, if we are not in the plan, we can take corrective action and we can check what are the causes. What are these corrective actions? We might say, okay, we need to do revised plan. Revise the plan, it means this is our mistake from a contractor point of view. We have delays, so we need to make a revised plan. When we should do a revised plan? We should do a revised plan when the scope changes or we have variation orders. And as we agreed, the revised plan will allow us to change the project completion date. And it is most likely not our mistakes from a contractor point of view. We can also make a recovery plan if the delays or the sequencing of work or the stages or the zones are not working as per the plan. It means this is the contractor mistake, so he need to do a recovery plan to maintain the original completion date of the project. We might also do some risk response plans, and in that case we will discuss later on in the course what are the risks, what are the responses to each risk. So this is some of the corrective actions. We can think about what are the causes of the delays if we are not on the plan. It might be scope creep, that we keep changing the scope of works. It might be some risks, unforeseen events happened, might be issues. You might ask yourself now, what are the differences between risks and issues? Risks are something might happen and might not happen. And as I told you, we'll have a separate lecture in the lessons for risks. But for now, I need only to know that the risks, something might happen, might not happen. Not sure. Issues or something already happened. This is the main difference between the risk and issues. What also could be the causes of deviation of the plan? It is a poor planning or the cost overrun because of communication issues or anything else. Okay, so now we need to know whether we are in plan or not on plan, because this will decide whether what are the corrective action we are going to take and define the causes and try to avoid them in the future. So our session will be as follow: how to manage and monitor the project in the execution phase and stay on plan, problems that faces projects in the execution phases and how to avoid them, corrective actions that should be taken if you are not on the plan. So let's go and see first of all the project progress. So as we execute our project, we need to monitor the progress to know how we are performing towards the baseline. So as we build our project on the three axis of time, cost, and quality, as we discussed before, we need to monitor the project against them. So we need to have schedule control, quality control, and cost control. Let's start with schedule control, where earned value management is the most effective way in progress measurement. Let me remind you with the earned value management terms, we find this nice photo, which will give you the formulas required for any EVM term. So the basic here is the earned value, and we have here planned value, we have here actual cost. So earned value minus actual cost equal to cost variance. Earned value divided by actual cost will equal to cost performance index or CPI. Same here, earned value minus planned value will equal to schedule variance. Earned value divided by planned value will give us schedule performance index. So we talked about the earned value management, where we have the planned percentage, actual percentage, planned value, earned value, schedule variance, and the schedule performance index. Let's see how we can calculate these numbers theoretically and how it can be calculated in Primavera P6 also. So here, from this snapshot of any schedule, you can simply say the planned percentage and the actual percentage, right? We agreed that the planned percentage equal to schedule percentage complete, and the actual percentage will be equal to performance percentage complete. So here we have the planned percentage is 20.77, the actual is 18%. Let's take an example. If we have a planned percentage of 20.77, the actual is 18%, and the project cost is 500,000. What could be the planned value? Planned value equal to total cost multiplied by planned percentage. So we have here the total cost, and we have here the planned percentage. Easily we can calculate the planned value, which is this number. Earned value. What is the formula for earned value? Do you remember? Total cost multiplied by actual percentage complete, because it's earned, actual, planned, planned. So total cost here is 500,000. We will multiply by the 18%. We will get the actual cost or earned value. What about schedule variance? In this example, we have planned percentage, actual percentage, planned value, earned value, and project cost. Schedule variance, if you remember, will equal to earned value minus planned value. So here, from the data above, we have here 90,000 minus 103,000. We have here minus 13,850. This schedule variance is less than 1. It means we are behind the schedule. But behind the schedule alone will not give us indication how much we are behind the schedule. So this number could give you an indication, and you compare it to the project cost, that we are behind the schedule with a work that worth 13,850. Also, another thing is a schedule performance index will give us a nice indication. The formula is earned value divided by planned value. So our performance, from its name, performance, are we performing 100% or more than 100% or less than 100%? So here we are 0.87. It means our performance is 87% only. You can make it as a percent or can make it as a number, whatever you like. So SPI is less than 1, it means we are behind the schedule. But how far we are behind the schedule, this is considered from this number. How far from 1? Because 1, we are on a schedule. More than 1, we are doing better than the schedule. Less than 1, we are doing worse than the schedule. Okay, so after updating the schedule and calculating the earned value manually for the schedule, we will learn how to do the same using Primavera. It is very simple. Why it is very simple? Because there are ready columns in Primavera will calculate everything for you. So we just need to show the planned value cost, earned value cost, schedule performance index, and the schedule variance. You will find the data here calculated automatically for you with no issues at all. If you imported the previous file for baseline schedule and updated schedule, you can do the same. I'm going to do it in front of you. So this is our schedule we created before, or we imported before. I would like to see the terms we talked about now. I have here the planned start, planned finish, start and finish, and I would like to add some more columns. So it is very simple. I'm going to the columns. So we need to find the planned value cost, earned value cost, schedule performance index, and the schedule variance. Here I'm going to search for planned value cost. Planned value, I can keep planned value, no need to type cost. So here I can find the planned value cost. I can simply double click and add it to my schedule. I can see also earned value. Earned value, I can search for it. Earned value cost, here it is. Now also I need a schedule performance index, so I can type schedule performance. You can type few words only to find the relevant field. And now I need schedule variance. Schedule variance, here it is. Of course I'm searching because I would like to tell you how to search, but you will find all these terms under earned value. Now I can arrange them. I'll put it here, the planned value, earned value, then schedule performance index and schedule variance. You can see all your information here. Definitely these numbers will be affected with any filter you are using. So here, removing all the filters, you will find the numbers are changing. So here I have my SPI, I have SV, schedule variance, earned value, planned value, as I wanted. If you check the calculation from P6 and the manual calculation, you will find them the same. Exactly the same, because it is the same concept. That's why I was interested to teach you how to calculate the EVM terms manually. Then definitely you can double check your calculation in Primavera. So after updating the schedule and calculating the earned value for the schedule, we will learn how to create simple progress dashboard to present the project data. We will use Excel to create this dashboard using the project data from Primavera. But before that, let us understand the differences between reports and dashboard in the next session. Hope you enjoyed this lesson and see you in the next one.